When you get infected with a virus, you don't feel sick right away. But the virus reproduces quickly, and the baby viruses end up in your snot, spit, and poo even before you feel ill. That's one reason a virus spreads so fast. But since those baby viruses also end up in the water we use to bathe, wash our hands, and flush our toilets, they all end up in the sewer, where they can serve as a warning before an outbreak breaks out. Spotting viral particles in the sewer, via wastewater surveillance, might seem like searching for a needle in a poop stack. But in 2001, scientists in Finland flushed a single polio vaccine down the toilet and detected viral particles from the vaccine at a wastewater treatment plant 20 miles downstream. And more recently, scientists found they could detect as few as 10 cases of COVID from the wastewater of more than 100,000 people. It's this kind of sensitivity, combined with the fact that people shed viruses before they even feel sick, that makes wastewater surveillance so powerful. Admittedly, it's also icky, and not just because it involves poop water. I mean, it's surveillance. Any personal data someone gathers about you, whether it's your health data or your browser history, can be used for bad just as easily as good. But surveillance of our sewers has more positives and fewer negatives than other forms of surveillance. Number one, unlike your browser history, which can point straight back to you, data from wastewater is anonymous. It can't tell that you are sick, only that someone is. And number two, scientists can use wastewater surveillance as an early warning system to detect outbreaks of a disease before other methods would, like testing symptomatic people, which, as you can imagine, is really helpful during something like a global pandemic. In 2020, many cities and countries started monitoring wastewater for the first time. If you're familiar with the term wastewater surveillance, that's probably why. But we release way more stuff than just viral particles into our sewers. If we can digest it, or if our bodies make it, remnants of it are likely to get flushed, which means a wealth of information goes down the drain every day. One study monitored a college campus's wastewater for hormones like adrenaline and cortisol to determine how stressed out students were over the course of a semester. And scientists have found that gut bacterial DNA that ends up in wastewater can tell a lot about a city's dietary habits and obesity rates, which can help make the case for better local health resources. But if we sample too far upstream, this type of surveillance can become invasive, and it may accidentally reinforce stigmas and stereotypes which already plague communities if we're not careful. However, wastewater surveillance, when done properly, is likely the least invasive way to gather this type of sensitive data accurately. So long as we're careful to set guidelines about wastewater surveillance and use the information we get from it responsibly, poopy water has a lot of potential to benefit public health. Or, should I say, public health. Wastewater surveillance is a powerful tool, but it's just one of many ways scientists are keeping an eye out for the next pandemic. And if you want to understand what would go into a worldwide plan to stop future pandemics from happening, check out Bill Gates' new book, aptly titled How to Prevent the Next Pandemic. Thanks to Bill for sponsoring this video, and for the work his foundation has done to ease the burden of disease around the world.